Bank News, the weather authority.
A storm system sweeps into southwest Florida. This is a live look in Fort Myers near Winkler and Colonial. The rain is coming down as the storm heads onto shore.
This is video from earlier today. Powerful winds and drenching rain are pushing in. Wink News is the weather authority. We have team coverage of the storm as it hits southwest Florida. Wink News reporter Oliver Redston is live on Fort Myers Beach as the wind pounds the shore. Meteorologist Janine Alpert is live in the studio detailing the forecast for the rest of the night. But we begin with Chief Meteorologist Jim Farrell as we track the storm system. Jim.
This is that line of showers and thunderstorms we've been telling you about for several days now, and it's coming through southwest Florida. Doesn't have quite the punch it could have had if it was a little stronger. We have had no reports of any severe weather wind damage in particular in the area. So far it's just rain and lightning. Take a look. It's pushing through eastern DeSoto County now, eastern Charlotte County, eastern Lee, and coastal Collier. There was some gusty wind earlier. The gust front was right in here where this red shade is. It's not as well defined now, but it matches up nicely with where the thunderstorms are. The white dots, of course, indicating lightning strikes. Now, here's what we're dealing with now. We've got thunderstorm activity from Highlands County southward to offshore Collier County, and it is still moving steadily to the northeast. But look at this. Charlotte County drying out now around Port Charlotte, Punta Gorda. The heaviest rain has ended. Same for Arcadia. It's light rain for you as the rain pushes into Highlands County. Farther south in Lee County, light rain. Cape Coral, Pine Island, Matlachet, Sanibel, Captiva. The heavy rain is over Lehigh Acres now. Gateway tracking off toward LaBelle, Alva. Watching that closely. South Fort Myers, Cypress Lake. It's light rain. The heaviest rain, though, is still nearby Estero, San Carlos Park, and Bonita Springs. From Daniels Parkway into Lehigh Acres, some heavy rain briefly for the next 30 minutes or so. Collier, you're last, but it's coming now, moving in off of the Gulf of Mexico, so thunder, lightning, some heavy rain for the Collier County coast. Time of arrival cone, Lehigh Acres, some more heavy rain for you right about now. Immokalee about 6:30. Everglades could be after 6:30. Moorhaven a little bit closer to 7 o'clock. Janine and I will be back in just a bit. We're going to give you an update on what to expect for the rest of the evening. And big changes are coming your way for tomorrow. I know you'll want to stay tuned to hear about that.
Thank you. Now we turn it over to Wink News reporter Oliver Redston, who's live on Fort Myers Beach. Oliver.
Well, John Carlos, we're standing at the edge of the boardwalk here on Fort Myers Beach, and the strong part of the storm just passed over us. You can actually see it to my south down here this way, and I want to give you an indication of just how strong it was at one point. That boat that you see off in the distance here, we actually couldn't see it. The rain and the wind were so intense, and you can see now the boardwalk, which was at one time very crowded here this evening, now totally empty. A lot of folks have gone inside realizing how strong the storm was. But one thing that we were noticing as we were standing out here tonight, it came on really quickly and it left really quickly. In the span of about 10 to 15 minutes, it went from being pretty much clear to really, really intense. And a lot of folks now gone inside. And just before the storm hit, we talked to people on the boardwalk here about how they were feeling, and the opinions varied.
You know, I was here during Irma, so it was really scary. Like, I lived in a two-story apartment, and we're just like, oh, we're gonna stay here because we didn't have time to leave. So, hey, I'm worried about it. I'm really worried about it.
I've been through these before. I just hang on. Yeah. It gets windy, it gets rainy, and I get wet.
And I'll just give you an idea of how strong the winds are still blowing here, even though a lot of the storm has passed over us. If you look off in the distance there, that flagpole you see just over that area on the boardwalk, you can see it's still blowing really intensely here. A lot of waves still crashing into the boardwalk area here. So the storm's still very intense, and it's moving to our south. Of course, we'll continue to follow the severe weather as it moves through our area. Stay tuned to Wink News. For now, live in Fort Myers Beach, Oliver Redston, Wink News Now.
Well, thank you, Oliver. And Wink News is the weather authority. You can find the latest forecast on the Wink News app. It's free, and we'll send you a push alert for any details you need to know. At noon tonight, another homicide investigation, the sixth in the last week. Wink News was first on the scene last night in Lehigh Acres. Witnesses tell us that a helicopter even touched down as sheriff deputies flooded the area. Now neighbors of the two victims say they are praying for everyone involved.
I say that I hope that you get the help that you need.
Wink News reporter Chris Grisby has the latest details from a neighborhood on edge.
There was a tragedy here at this house.
Family and friends are waiting patiently as the Lee County Sheriff's Office works to figure out how someone was killed inside this house last night.
It's a tragedy. I mean, she was a great woman. Her husband's in ICU. He's a great man.
People close to the family living here say an unfortunate attack left one person dead and another fighting for his life. Now, detectives are hard at work a day after the attack, trying to figure out how this incident began.
Oh, the police are investigating, and we'll all know more when they wrap that up.
As this homicide investigation unfolds, family and friends say they hope justice will be served.
I say that I hope that you get the help that you need.
Reporting in Lehigh Acres, Chris Grisby, Wink News Now.
Detectives working the case believe the incident is isolated. As soon as we learn more information, you can count on Week News to update you. And two children are dead from a rollover crash in a stolen car. Seven kids in total were inside the car in Pompano Beach early this morning. Everyone involved in the crash was between 12 to 14 years old. One victim died at the scene, the other at the hospital. Officials haven't released their identifications or exact ages.
Right now, crews are fighting back a mulch fire in North Naples. It's at Immokalee Road and Jones Mining Road. It started at around 1:30 this afternoon. They still don't know how it started, but they do say the wind fanned the flames. This is a developing story. We'll give you more information once we have it. We're working to find out what started a fire in a trailer early this morning. Crews responded to flames in the construction trailer along Innovation Boulevard in Estero. Officials say the trailer is a total loss, and how the fire started is suspicious. Count on Wink News to update you as we learn more. You might want to double check the eggs in your fridge. Over 206 million eggs from Rose Acre Farms are under a voluntary recall. The FDA warns of possible salmonella contamination. 22 illnesses are reported so far. The eggs were sold in 9 states, including Florida. If you did buy these eggs, you're encouraged to return them to get a refund or just throw them away. You can also find all the details about that recall on the Wink News app. We've posted the story to the top of the page.
And spreading their message near and far, students took their protest for stricter gun control outside the NRA headquarters in Virginia. Now, one of the protesters is Aaliyah Eastman. She survived the Marjorie Stoneman Douglas shooting in Parkland back in February.
Two of my classmates in the class passed away, Nicholas Dora and Helena Ramsey, and I hid underneath Nicholas Dora's body to stay alive.
She traveled up north from Florida to join the protest on Saturday. Aaliyah says she and the crowd are fed up with the status quo.
I was shot at with an AR-15, the same gun that they support. So it just makes me upset. But, you know, I think if we keep doing this, they'll maybe understand.
The students say they want more background checks and a ban on high-capacity magazines. The NRA did not respond for comment. And here in Florida, the other side share their concerns, too. Supporters of the Second Amendment rallied outside the Capitol in Tallahassee yesterday. Cities took across the country took part in a nationwide effort to call Americans for America. Advocates say taking away guns from law-abiding citizens won't stop criminals. They say they're fighting for their right to protect their families. And the president takes on James Comey again. President Donald Trump fired off a series of tweets at the former FBI director this morning. He called him a, quote, slimeball and claims he never asked for Comey for loyalty. The fire comes just hours before Comey sits down with a major network interview later tonight. Wink News reporter Laura Podesta has those details.
In the span of 2 hours early Sunday morning, President Trump fired off 5 tweets about former FBI director James Comey. One read, "Slippery James Comey, a man who always ends up badly and out of whack, he is not smart, will go down as the worst FBI director in history by far." President Trump fired Comey last year, citing his handling of the FBI's investigation into Hillary Clinton's use of her personal email while Secretary of State. In a new tell-all book to be released this week, Comey discloses why he reopened the email investigation so close to Election Day.
She's going to be elected president, and if I hide this from the American people, she'll be illegitimate the moment she's elected, the moment this comes out.
Trump seized on that, tweeting that Comey was making decisions based on the fact that he thought she was going to win and he wanted a job. Slimeball. On the Sunday morning news shows, politicians also reprimanded Comey's actions.
I do think that he made a very serious mistake in discussing the Clinton investigation 2 weeks out.
Jim Comey is a good man who made a very consequential blunder.
In the book, Comey describes President Trump as a bully who is untethered to truth and compares his inner circle to the mafia, lying about all things large and small. Laura Podesta, CBS News.
Comey did some tweeting of his own on Sunday, writing in part, "Three presidents are in my book. Two help illustrate the values of the heart of ethical leadership. One serves as a counterpoint. I hope folks read the whole thing and find it useful."
A family says their baby was stolen from them just days after she was born. How they say police were involved in her kidnapping, coming up on Wink News.
And a line of rain and thunderstorms right now, especially moving through Collier up towards Eastern Lee. We'll be back with Chief Meteorologist Jim Farrell to tell you about this line of storms and the pleasant weather coming after it. Stay with us.
And Week News is the Weather Authority. We are tracking a storm system as it moves across southwest Florida. This is a live look at Fort Myers Beach. You can see the rain there hitting the camera lens. Now, right now, we turn it over to Chief Meteorologist Jim Farrell and Janine Albert. Today marks 5 years since the Boston Marathon bombings. The city of Boston held a moment of silence this afternoon at 2:49 p.m., the time the bombs went off in 2013. Families of the victims laid ceremonial wreaths at the finish line. Three people died in the bombings, and 260 others were hurt. One of the suspects died at a shootout with police in the days afterwards. His brother was arrested, tried, convicted, and sentenced to death.
And stay with us. More team weather coverage is coming up next.